My grandparents died 10 years ago and they own a land property po. They, yung grandparents po, they have 5 children, including po yung sender's father, who was already dead 20 years ago. Now, the main problem arose po when a telecommunication company was interested in the land property. So, yung auntie po nung sender, siya po yung nagpa-process ng necessary papers. And the auntie declared that their deceased brother or yung tatay po ng sender had no children nung nabubuhay pa siya. The reason is the difficulty of producing the signature of the sender and his siblings, if any po. Now, because of this po, dahil daw po sa pandemic. Now, may 2 questions po siya. Ano daw po ang pwedeng gawin? At pangalawa po, if there is a misdeclaration or misinformation, is it a ground po ba to render the contract void daw po?
Thank you, Aaron, no, for reading that question. So, nakita namin dito, okay, nagkaroon ng parang falsification na tinatawag. Later that you'll discuss it, Aaron, for me, kailangan mo differentiate between a falsification of a commercial document and public document. Pero first off, yung tatay niya, no, inherited the property together with his auntie and other siblings. They became co-owners of the property. So they co-owned the property with each sibling owning 20% kasi lima nga sila, no? 1/5, no? 1/5 share. When the father died, his children, o yung mga ano niya, yung mga kapatid din niya, you and your siblings stepped into the shoes of the father and the children became co-owners of the 20% na nakuha ng tatay nila na namatay. So this is by right of representation according to the succession law, no? According to the civil code. As co-owner, your signatures are required to transfer full ownership over the property. However, it should be noted that the sale will not be voided as a whole. Kasi sabi nga, yung right of co-heirs can have the transfer of their inchoate interest na tinatawag.
Yes, po.
So, pwede nilang i-void yun. Yung pwede lang nilang i-void is yung parte nila. No, yung share nila na 20%. Pero merong isang issue dito, Aaron, yung falsification of commercial documents. Anong masasabi mo dito?
Ayun po. So nasabi nga po kanina na meron daw po misdeclaration na walang anak yung kapatid nila na tatay nung sender. No, ngayon po, under the revised penal code po, we have Article 172, which is the falsification by private individual and use of falsified document po. Now, in Article 172 po, yung document po is either a public document or a commercial document. So either way po, a public document or commercial document man, pinapunish po ng Article 172 of the revised penal code ang pag-falsify o at ang paggamit po ng falsified document to cause damage to another. Ngayon po, pag sinabi po natin public document, ang isang deed of absolute sale po, kapag ito po ay na-notarize, it becomes a public document according po sa desisyon ng Korte Suprema na Rosales versus Ramos. Notarization converts a private document into a public document. Now, pag sinabi naman po natin commercial document, sa isang desisyon naman po ng Korte Suprema, sabi din po ng Supreme Court, documents used by merchants or businessmen to promote or facilitate trade are called commercial documents po. So, ayun po.
Ayun, galing. Saan mo nakuha yan?
Aaron. Legal Wiz po, attorney.
So, basically, yung sagot natin, kinuha natin sa My Legal Wiz, no? And then we just customize it for our sender ng question. So, magandang sagot yun. So, basically, falsification of a commercial document. And of course, they are co-owners of their share dito sa property na to ng grandfather nila because of right of representation.